Battlefronts 2 new updates here, and it's a pretty juicy one. I'm not gonna lie to you. So, as of yesterday, Monday, February 3rd, the new Battlefront update has come out, which is the community update for BB-8 and BB-9E, which, start off, those are the two new heroes, which I'm still not sure about all of these since it's really the most random characters, but they added BB-8 from, you know, the sequels, the main droid, which is like, I guess like, not the replacement for R2, but like the same purpose as R2, you get your point. Then for the First Order, they put in BB-9E, because remember him? Yeah, I don't either. So, that's the hero stuff, and while they have some pretty good abilities, the thing here is that BB-8 is more of like an attack player, which I'll show up his abilities on screen now. He has like, the most fun thing to use is his like, I forget what it's called, but it's his wires come out and you just spin around and just whipping people with wires, which, you know, you did that as a kid, but to a little less extreme, and it's fun doing that. And just all around, he's a more aggressive player, and to keep it real, it's BB-8. He's a little small ball, so killing him is going to be pretty hard, since not only does he move pretty fast, but he gets pretty small, and shooting that little thing is pretty hard. The only problem is that if you have a lightsaber character, it'll probably take you out pretty easily. So it's kind of like a positive and a negative adding together. So yeah, but for most people that are playing just assault people or officers or wherever, it's gonna be pretty hard to kill BB-8. And with that comes BB-9E, which is just basically BB-8, just instead of the head being a semicircle, which more of like a concave head. So he is a very interesting choice because he's actually the only new character I got to play since. Good luck playing BB-8 out of an hour of gameplay. I did not get him once at all because you really have to be the first to get to 4,000 points and get him instantly, which I assure you someone's going to do it faster. And once you don't get him the first time, it's over because that one first person is going to hog the shit out of him. He's going to camp so he doesn't die. He's going to run away. He's going to make sure he doesn't die. If he doesn't die, he's still going to get it before you. So if you don't get BB-8 on the first try, then you're screwed. You're just not getting him. But BB-9E is a little easier because no one cares about him. Sorry, but it's true. And I got to play him way more. Now, BB-9E is interesting because he's more of a support player. He just kind of... It's the best way I could put it. He's a support player. He's obviously up close and personal, which they both are because they don't have any blasters or anything. But BB-9E just kind of sucks damage-wise. It takes forever to kill someone with him. And he has basically the same thing with the wires, but it's a shock charge, which is just like little shock bolts coming out at you, which does way less damage and is just assisting and helping. And he has a smoke grenade, which can get him out of a sticky situation, and it will pin enemies in red so you can see them. Then his other one, which I'm still not sure what it is, but it's just kind of there. Really doesn't help at all, since from the three times I used him, if I still don't know what it is, that just shows it. But other from that, his main attack is like a shock, which is just you pull out a little zapper and you zap people, which again takes forever to kill. So he really sucks damage wise and the best way to use him is if you're supporting someone. So if you're on like A site and there's a Kylo there and you want to win the game, BB-9E is going to be great for winning the game. He's gonna be there for support and that's his only role. He sucks at being aggressive. But he also has the same thing of BB-8 where he could get around fast and he's small as hell, so good luck killing him. And also, they both jump, which I kind of dislike this because if you looked in the movie, there's a motion or I guess a scene where BB-8 falls and you can really hear how much he weighs. And when you jump in this, I really wish you could hear how much they weigh so you could just get that like feel of like, okay, they're heavy droids, but that's just me nitpicking because I'm a fucking nerd. But other from that, supremacy in this game, they've updated that quite a lot. So what they did is that originally it was a prequel only mode, which, you know, I'm not gonna lie, it gets kind of stale after a while since it's like four maps or three maps that you're playing over and over, which, don't get me wrong, I still and will always love the prequels and have them as my favorite era wise. Jesus, that's a tongue twister for me. But with this, they added the sequel trilogy, which cool. I would imagine they will down the road add the original trilogy, but with this, the maps are Attack of Dawn of Jakku and Azon Kloss, which, cool. I mean, I like Attack of Dawn, and the only reason I remember is because it sounds like Madonna, but other from that, it's just there. But one cool thing that I really like about this is that there's new Star Destroyers you could go in, or I guess ships you could go on. So, okay, if you don't know what Supremacy is, first off, I don't know what you're doing watching this video, but Supremacy is, you get these objectives, alright? It's like King of the Hill or Capture the Flag, where you have to obtain these objectives first to a certain amount of points, goes to phase 2. Phase 2, you go onto a ship and you attack it, and the prequels, it would be a Separatist and a Republic ship, and here, you have the MC-85 Starcruiser, which is cool. I mean, yeah, I don't really care that much. But then you're going on a fucking Star Destroyer for the first Resistance. Like, who has never wanted to be on a Star Destroyer? It's just, it's gonna be pretty fun going in there, and it is pretty fun going in there. But that's all the stuff for Supremacy. I'm not sure what they're gonna do, you know, down the line with it. You can also choose which era you want now. So it's not like PUBG back in the day where you just chose Supremacy and it was just throw you an arrow, you don't really have a choice, so good for them. I enjoy that. But other from that, that's all the important stuff. Then some useless stuff is that Hero Showdown is now on Azon Kloss again, which cool. Then there's new emotes for Finn and Kylo, which don't know how to get. Haven't looked, don't care that much, but they're cool, I guess. And other from that, later this month, or I think next month, I forget when, we're getting the original trilogy in co-op. Yeah, so if you watch my last Battlefront video, which you could do in the top right hand corner of your screen now, if you watched it, I say in it, please give us original trilogy co-op. And literally the next day, I shit you not, Wednesday, the day after that video, they did it. Or was it Friday? The point is, they announced that, okay, we're putting original trilogy in co-op, and I went crazy, because first off, I was like, coincidence? I think not. Then, it's original trilogy. I don't know why, but I've just been so obsessed with that so recently. You know, if you don't know, co-op is really the main thing I play, and they just announced it for it, and I'm just really excited for that. I forget which maps they're adding to it, but I'm pretty sure they're adding a Rogue One map, which is, Rogue One is just a flawed masterpiece. I'm just keeping it at that. But anyways, this update has been pretty great. It's just amazingly fun to play. Excited for the rest of this month and all the stuff that's coming to it. Glad DICE is keeping up with Battlefront 2. Other from that, I will see you Thursday. Goodbye.